UPSC Collegiate English. Today we will see yet another poem, On the Move by Tom Gunn. Tom Gunn was an English poet who was praised for his early verse. He was associated with movement, looser, free verse style. His verse became increasingly bold in its exploration of drugs and homosexuality and poetic form. His verse is known for its adroit, terse language and counterculture themes. Bohemian lifestyle in San Francisco, that's what he practiced, and that is what his work reflects. He was interested in syllabics and free verse. Now coming to the movement. The movement was a term coined by J.D. Scott, literary editor of The Spectator, to describe a group of writers including Philip Larkin, Kingsley Amis, Donald Davey, D.J. Enright, John Wayne, Elizabeth Jennings, Tom Gunn, and Robert Conquest. To these poets, poetry meant simple, sensuous, traditional, and dignified form. Now, there were two anthologies published by the movement poets. One was Poets of 1950s, and the second one is New Lines. Now, coming to the poetry collection of Tom Gunn, they are The Sense of Movement, My Sad Captain, Touch, Molly, Jack Straw's Castle, The Passage of Joy. Now, let us analyze the poem as such. The blue jay scuffling in the bushes follows some hidden purpose, and the gust of birds that spurts across the field, the wheeling swallows, has nested in the trees and undergrowth. Seeking their instinct or their poise or both, one moves with an uncertain violence under the dust thrown by a baffled sense or the dull thunder of approximate words. So let us discuss this stanza. Tom Gunn in this stanza compares human beings, particularly gangs, that is the motorcyclist, with birds. The blue jay, which scuffles in the bushes, had some hidden need in doing so. The group of birds, those are flying across the field, has some intention. The swallows have their nests in trees and low-level bushes. Every bird has been guided by instinct or according to their need and purpose. Now, he brings these gangs into the poem saying, one moves with uncertain violence, which means one is going very fast on the bike, raging with violence as it might lead to accidents. The motorist is driving crazily like this. The first stanza provides contrasting nature of human beings with birds, and the craziness for speed is described. Coming to the next stanza. On the motorcycles, up the road they come, small, black, as flies hanging in heat. The boys, until the distance throws them forth, their hum bulges to thunder held by calf and thigh. In goggles, dunned in personality. In gleaming jackets, trophied with the dust. They strap in doubt by hiding it robust, and almost hear a meaning in their noise. Coming to the explanation. In this stanza, Tom Gunn wants to project a picture of long shot to close shot of motorcycle gangs coming from a long and top of the road to nearer sight. He describes as if he is closely monitoring them. He sees the gangs coming. He compares the motorcyclists to flies. When he sees them in a long distance, they appear as small creatures like flies in black color, as they have worn the black jackets hanging in heat. This is what he assumes when he sees gangs in distance. Then the distance throws them to come further. That means they are coming near. The distant sound of humming turns into thunder sound with a raising sound emancipated from the vehicles. He says they are driving them held by calf and thigh. They wear goggles not to be disturbed by the dust emanated from their vehicles. He calls them impersonalities. The shining jackets are turned into dusty, and he is saying that jackets are trophied with dust. Their sound is unbearable, but they can hear meaning in the created noise. Coming to the next stanza. Exact conclusion of their hardiness has no shape yet, but from known whereabouts they write direction where the tires press. They scare a flight of birds across the field, much that is natural to the will must yield. Men manufacture both machine and soul and use what they imperfectly control to dare a future from the taken roots. Now coming to the analysis. In this stanza, Thomgun explains how they are disturbing and the repercussions of the scientific inventions. He says that there is no fatigue affecting them in their journeys. They do not know where they are going. They do not know where they will stay. The swallows have nest, but these motorcyclists do not have a shelter, at least like them. They travel in that way. They travel in ways where their vehicles can go. They travel without purpose, and at the same time, they fear the birds which are flying across the fields. These birds follow their instincts and needs, but these gangs are against it. Their destination is not known to them. Thomgun is referring to the scientific inventions, especially machines. He says that men made machines as well as their personalities. He says men are using what they cannot use perfectly and they control it imperfectly. They only consider their present, leaving future to the fate. Coming to the next stanza, it is a part solution after all. One is not necessarily discord on earth or damned because half animal. One lacks direct instinct because one wakes afloat on movement that divides and breaks. One joins the movement in a valueless world, choosing it till both hurler and the hurled, one moves as well, always toward. Thomas Gunn is referring the state of bike men. He uses the word half animal. He says that they lack the instinct and without any purpose, they move on without any destination and target. They only love present going speed. It is violent speed disturbs the flight of birds and the human beings who are with the destination. The speed attracts accidents and the loss respectively. He says that no one sleeps as he is saying one wakes afloat on moment. One motorbike gang lives in this world without values. There is no need of destination for them. They are always traveling forward. Coming to the next stanza, a minute holds them who have come to go. The self-defined astride the created will. They burst away. The towns they travel through are home for neither bird nor holiness. For birds and saint complete their purposes. At worst, one is in motion and at best, reaching no absolute in which to rest. One is always nearer by not keeping still. Coming to the explanation, Thomgun is explaining how these bike men travel and where they would leave to. They sit astride and speed up their vehicles to unknown destiny. He used self-denied in the stanza to refer to the gangs. They travel through towns where there are no nests for birds and homes for holiness. It is because saints and birds have purposes in life. They travel in that direction. But these speedy motor gangs do not have any purpose. Hence, they are traveling away from them. They say they should be on the move always. They want to enjoy the speed without any intention. They are marred with dust. These do not bother them. They are at their worst while they are on the move. They are in continuous motion. Thus, they are always nearer to the final rest, that is death. Okay, so speaking about this poem, this is a celebration of black-jacketed motorcycles. The subtitle of the poem is, "On the Move, Man, You Gotta Go." This is the intended words to describe the lifestyle of motorcycle gangs of 1950s who are byproducts of altering civilization and inventions spurted in the given periods. Thomgun, in his poems, describes the lifestyle of these gangs and provides a message through this attempt. So we have come to the conclusion of this poem. Thank you so much and keep learning, friends.